You know, these biryanis are delicate in their flavor. In this chili chicken, that fresh flavor of that green chili is what's more apparent than the heat of the green chili. Ooh, I love that lush, buttery texture. Bende tara karagi ho gaya tha that fat. And that meat is soft and tender. You know, I'm very grateful to the fact that Raju is allowing us access to watch the making of his biryani.
Just on secret to yaar kuda olagada, including my relative only, yaar kumba close friends olagada karakapam thosila.
Hi folks, this is Kripal Amana, Gourmet on the Road, and you're watching Food Lovers TV. I hope you're doing well. So it's a bright sunny afternoon here in Bengaluru, and I feel like eating some local style donne biryani. Now those of you who follow the show know that I have my favorites, but today I thought I will try something new. And this one isn't called the donne biryani, it is called the jhonne biryani. This biryani place has been around for a few years, but in that relatively short time, as opposed to some of the donne biryani institutions, this place has amassed for itself a considerable following. For some reason, I haven't had the opportunity to taste this particular biryani yet. So this afternoon, I'm going to make amends and head to Halli Jhonne Biryani to taste their biryani. So stick around to find out what this biryani is all about and also why it's called the Jhonne Biryani. I have absolutely no idea, but I hope to find out.
We're in the hustle of Jayanagar 4th block here in South Bengaluru, and that's where we are headed to taste the Jhonne Biryani. So I'm with Mr. Raju.
Yes, sir.
New start madido. Halli Jhonne Biryani.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Eshtu varsha hinde?
Sir, 10 years hinde madidhi, sir.
10 years hinde.
Ondu mobile canteen start madido.
Ondu
road side alli. So avaga 25 rupees itti biryani.
25 rupees.
25 rupees start madido.
Elli ittu adu?
Sir, Doddikalli andre, sir. Doddikalli andre, sir. Alli start.
So road side tal gaadi alli.
Hauda, hauda, hauda.
Elli yavaga bandadu?
Still 5 years aayitu, sir.
5 years aayitu. ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಡೆ ದೊನ್ನೆ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊನ್ನೆ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಅದು
ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇದು ಹಳ್ಳಿ ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಟಿದೀವಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ವಿಲೇಜ್ ನೇಮು ಜೊನ್ನೆ ಅಂತ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರಿಂಗ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಈ ಜೊನ್ನೆ ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊನ್ನೆ ಅಂತಾನೆ ಪ್ರೊನೌನ್ಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಸೊ ಹಳ್ಳಿನಲ್ಲಿ ದ ಪ್ರೊನೌನ್ಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಕಮ್ ಜೊನ್ನೆ ಒಂದು
ಜೊನ್ನೆ
ಜೊನ್ನೆ
ಸೊ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ದ ದೊನ್ನೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದ ದೊನ್ನೆ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಎಲ್ಸ್ವೇ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಟ್ ಬಾಸ್ಕೆಟ್
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್ ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್
ದಟ್ ಬೂಟಿ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ದೇ ಸರ್ವ್ ದ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದ ದೊನ್ನೆ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ದೊನ್ನೆ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಎವ್ರಿವೇರ್ But what I'm given to understand from Mr. Raju here is that where these buttis are made in the halli, in the villages, alli jonne karitare.
Yes, sir, jonne karitare. Kannada word ide. Adu donne antane ide adu. Actually, this pronunciation jonne antide.
Matte idu halli andre halli connection enu, halli recipe.
Village. Ella naati style alli, ella kottambari, pudina, idella naati style alli martidivala. So adakke halli antane ittukonde.
From selling that jonne biryani in a push cart, he now has an eatery. ಎಷ್ಟು ಜನರು ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ
ಸರ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ದಿನಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು 500 ಜನ ಬರ್ಬೋದು 500 1000 ಜನ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ನಾನೊಬ್ಬ ಹೈಯೆಸ್ ಆಸ್ಪಿರೆಂಟ್ ಸೊ ಬಡತನ ಓದ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬಿಡಲಿಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ನಾನು ಇದನ್ನು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಸೊ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ವರ್ಕು ಆನೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇದು ತುಂಬ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯಿತು ಸೊ ಈ ಮಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೆ
ಸೊ ಇದರ ಮುಂಚೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರಿ ನೀವು ತಳಗಾಡಿ ಮುಂಚೆ
ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಮುಗಿಸ್ತು ಸರ್
ಬಿ ಕಾಮ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನಲ್ಲಿ
ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್ನಲ್ಲಿ
ಸೊ ಅವಾಗ ಜಾಬ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಹುಡುಕ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ
ಜಾಬ್ ಏನು ಹುಡುಕ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ರಾತ್ರಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಿದ್ದೆ
ಸೊ ಏನು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರಿ
ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಪೇಪರು STD book.
So from those humble beginnings where he was studying and also working to support his family at that time, whether it's delivering milk, papers, he then after completing the degree decided to set up a push cart serving the Halli Jhonne Biryani.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
And then 5 years on, he has his eatery which serves on a given day between 500 to 1000 people.
Yes, sir.
That's truly an inspiring story of the journey that Raju has made over the last 10 years.
Yes.
Fantastic, Ri.
Thank you, sir.
Super. That's the spirit. You know, we are all in a situation where things are difficult, things are challenging, but I think we should draw inspiration from stories like these. The world can be topsy-turvy, Life can seem challenging. There may be dark clouds on the horizon. But if you want to do something,
hard work and honesty.
Hard work and honesty.
Yes.
You can definitely make a success. Change. And you can be successful at that. Fantastic. It's nice to see all the greats of Karnataka.
With respect.
So these are the personalities that showcase Karnataka to the world. Fantastic to see that as soon as you walk into the establishment, that's the first thing that you see. So that's the menu here.
Yes, sir. Few items sustain. Mutton birni, mutton fry, mutton liver, chicken birni, chicken fry. Yalla pura special. Menu tumba kadmi ide. But adanne tumba chennaga achkata kuda unbekunnadu namma uddesha.
I'm already liking what I hear. Raju here has a small menu. Na nortidene ondu 5-6 dish ide
illi. Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes.
But he says, I will do fewer dishes, but I will do them well.
Yes, sir.
What is also interesting is that mutton bari 180 rupees.
Actually, nanu plan itu chain madlike. Due to COVID, janratra ekonomi tumba kashta ide. So inta ondu situation lo rate ella jaasti maadi maadod beda anta nanu rate carry maartidini. This is my sister.
Namaskara. Nimde hesarenu?
Bhagya.
Bhagya. Nice to meet you.
This is my own brother. Cookie.
Namaskara. Nimde hesarenu?
Mahesh.
Mahesh.
One more brother is there, Raju.
Raju.
Yes.
So all three.
Yes.
And the sister also.
Sister.
So there are four of you.
Four of us.
So the entire family is involved in this business.
Yes, sir. This is the mutton chop, sir.
Mutton chop. So idu nimdu sheep or goat?
Sometime sheep tagond bartini ona sari goat sigutte ivattella sheep ide ivattu
ella kuri ivattu
ella kuri ide ivattu olle kuri ide ivattu chilli coriander kottambari pudina matte pepper lavanga matte
adhe eno
pepper mutton liver sir idu
that looks like a thick gravy here
masala salpa paste madi hakini sir adu ginger garlic onion paste la salpa jaasti madi salpa gravy kelthara jana. So biryani olle combination.
So ella new paste martira.
Onion ella paste.
So raw onion hakalla paste mari
hastira.
Onion, ginger, garlic.
Yes sir.
Idralli tomato ideya?
Solpa tomato idu hakidini sir.
Solpa tomato idralli illa.
Adralli illa sir. Onnadondona different taste varbekalla. Onde thara ella same masala agibidare.
That deg is hot and almost squealing in excitement as it meets that oil. We are watching the making of that haldi jonne biryani. Here at Haldi Jonne Biryani with Ninga Raju, who's also fondly known as Raju. That's the cardamom.
Yes.
That's going in.
Lavanga.
Some cloves. Cassia. Star anise. Marat Moggu going in. Some fennel that's going in. Bay leaf. Iga onion and mint. So as soon as he gets some aroma of the spices,
yes, sir, yes, sir.
That's when he knows. That is time to place the onion and the mint inside that biryani deg. And already I can smell the aroma of that mint. Ginger garlic paste. And now I can smell the pungent aroma of that garlic.
Masuru.
Masuru, some masuru. Yogurt.
Correct.
So yogurt in the end agate.
Shunti matte belluli paste. Ah. That's a good taste for the meat kuda chennagi melt agate.
Turmeric.
Yes sir.
There's plenty of turmeric.
Saluto. Kasturi mente.
The dried fenugreek that's gone in. And some more yogurt. He says that yogurt basically helps remove some of the raw aromas of the ginger garlic paste and also makes the meat softer. So the mutton is going in now.
ದಿನಕ್ಕೆದು ನಾನು ಒಂದು ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಸರ್
ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಟೈಮ್
ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ
ಸೊ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟಿಲ್ ನೈಟ್
ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟಿಲ್ ನೈಟ್
ಐ ಲವ್ ದ ವೇ ದ ಮೀಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನೌ ಕಂಬೈನಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಮಸಾಲಾ ವಿತ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೈಸಿಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಜಿಂಜರ್ ಗಾರ್ಲಿಕ್ ಪೇಸ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಆನಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ನಾಟ್ ಟು ಫರ್ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಟರ್ಮರಿಕ್ ದಟ್ ಪಿಂಕ್ ಮೀಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನೌ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಲೈಟ್ ಯೆಲೋ ಯು ನಿಮ್ದು ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಯೆಲೋವಿಶ್ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ಲ
ಯೆಲ್ಲೋ ಇಲ್ಲ ಲೆಮನ್ ಯೆಲ್ಲೋ ಇರ್ತದೆ
ಲೆಮನ್ ಯೆಲ್ಲೋ
ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ
ಸೊ ಈ ಸೇಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಲೆಮನ್ ಯೆಲ್ಲೋ ವಿತ್ ಅ ಹಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್
ಯೆಸ್
ಸರ್ ಸಮ್ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್
ಸಾಲ್ಟ್
ಏನಿದು
ಸರ್ ಇದು ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಕೊತ್ತಂಬರಿ ಪುದೀನ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫ್ರೈ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಆ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಒಂದು ರಾ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ತೆಗೆದಾಕಿ ಒಂದು ಪೇಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಟ್ಕೊಂಡು
ಓ I was so excited about this biryani coming together. I forgot to remove my shades. Now I can see that vivid yellowish green.
Yes, sir.
Of that biryani. So what's interesting is the fact that he makes a paste. He fries the green chilies, the coriander and the mint. Till what time do you fry it?
5 minutes, sir.
Five minutes. He fries it and I think it releases some of its essential oils.
Yes,
and then he grinds it and that is what is added to this deg of biryani. Idella nindu spices, ha?
Avudu, sir.
Turmeric, kasuri methi, the dried fenugreek.
Om kaalu.
So the ajwain.
Yes, sir, ajwain.
Coriander powder.
Idu halli jonne biryani special masala.
Halli jonne biryani special masala.
Yes.
Star anise, fennel.
Yes, sir, yes.
Jeera.
Lavanga. Adu ilachi. ಮತ್ತೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ ಫ್ಲವರ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇದೆ ಮಸಾಲೆ
ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ರೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರ
ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಸಾಲೆ ಗೊತ್ತು ಅದರ ಅಳತೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಮಾಣ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅದು ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಅದೇ ಸೀಕ್ರೆಟ್
ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅದೇ ರೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಅಸ ಸೀಕ್ರೆಟ್
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್ ಎಸ್ ಸರ್
ಇದು ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ
ನಾವೇ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಸರ್ ಇಲ್ಲೇನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ
ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ
ಸರ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಿಪರೇಷನ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದನೇ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ
ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಮಸಾಲಾ ಇಸ್ ನೌ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್
ಕೊರಿಯಾಂಡರ್ ಸರ್
ಕೊರಿಯಾಂಡರ್ ಪೌಡರ್ Some ajwain has gone in.
White pepper, sir.
White pepper.
Salpa mutton masala.
Mutton masala.
Yes, sir. Salpa garam masala.
Some garam masala.
Yes, sir.
And some shahi biryani masala.
Yes.
So what I like is that he's got, these are masalas that he grinds at home. And the masalas that he buys ready-made, he buys from brands. So quality brands.
Yes, sir. Quality brands only.
So I think they make their own masalas and then they add some of it to fortify the flavors.
Yes, sir.
This is tough work.
Yes.
I think that explains for his big guns.
Yes. Istan secret to yaru kuda olagade including my relative only yare thumba close friends olagade karakondo thosilla.
You know, I'm very grateful to the fact that Raju is allowing us access to watch the making of his biryani. He says I typically don't share it with anybody, but he says for some reason
Yes,
I feel like I want to share it with you and we are grateful for that, Raju.
Thank you, sir. And also, chicken, mutton selection is very important.
So he says he needs about 10 or 15 lambs every day.
Yes.
Each animal should be 8, 9 or 10 kilos, so tender.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So he buys the entire animal, gets it butchered, and then he makes different things. Skull soup, liver,
yes, sir.
Biryani, Malinga chops.
Chops.
Mutton keema.
ಕಿಲೋ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು ಇವತ್ತು ಒಂದು ಕಿಲೋ 250-300 kilos ಅಕ್ಕಿ ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ
500 kilos ಇನ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ 250 kilos ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಟನ್ ಚಿಕನ್ ಅಂಡ್ 250 kilos ಆಫ್ ದ ರೈಸ್
ಎವ್ರಿ ಡೇ
ಸರ್ ವೀಕೆಂಡ್ಗೆ
ವೀಕೆಂಡ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್ ಅದು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ನಾನು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನೇಮ್ ಇಟ್ಟಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಹೊಸ ಹೊಸ ಪಾತ್ರೆ ಬೈ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ರೋಡ್ ಸೈಡಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಟಾಗ ಪಾತ್ರೆಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಹೊಸದು ಶೈನಿಂಗ್ ಇತ್ತು ಬಂದು ಜನ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸು ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಿರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಪಾತ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಿದ್ರು ಸೊ ನಿನಗೆ ಅದು ತುಂಬ ಅಳು ಬರ್ತು ಎಂತ ರಾಂಗ್ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ತಗೊಂಡೆ ಅಂತ ಸೊ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವಮಾನ ಅನುಮಾನ ಸನ್ಮಾನ ಇದು ತುಂಬ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಇದು ಸನ್ಮಾನದ ಒಂದು ಲೆವೆಲ್ ನನಗೆ ಅವಮಾನ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅನುಮಾನ ಇದೆರಡು ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಈ ಮಟ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀನಿ
ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈ ಸೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಲೈಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ 3 ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಬಿಗಿನ್ ಟು ಡೌಟ್ ಅನುಮಾನ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ರೀಚ್ ಅ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ವೇರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ರಿಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ರಿಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ವರ್ಕ್ And that is the level, the stage of Sanmana.
Yes.
Sanmana or success.
Yes.
But that's fascinating. So from Raju already, I have learned a
yes.
certain philosophy to
yes.
his life.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
That he felt insulted first. He had doubts about what he was doing. But then he continued with what he was doing.
Yes.
And he's finally reached a level where he gets Sanmana for the work and the food that
yes.
he does.
Right.
Fantastic. How wonderful is that?
Gravy, sir,
this is the sherwa or that gravy that gets served with each biryani. Looking at that huge cauldron, you get a sense of how many biryanis go out from this kitchen every day. And now some hot water is going in. This is the water that's going in to cook the rice. Some more salt and this salt is for the rice. So there's also some cashew that goes in to enrich the biryani a bit more. Lime juice. Flavors are definitely more stronger, but once he adds the rice, yes. that rice will soak up.
Yes, sir.
So now you may feel the edge of the salt, yes. You may feel the edge of the spice a little more. But rice aakid mele, rice ella tagolutta. The rice absorbs everything.
Yes.
Soak martira rice?
Yes sir, 10 to 15 minutes.
10 to 15 minutes. And what rice is it?
Sir, jeera rice. Sir.
Siraga sambar rice?
Yes, jeera sambar.
So now that rice has gone in, eega ghee. So basically that ghee ensures that the rice doesn't stick to each other. So is the rice ishta magade cook aglike?
One 10 minutes sir.
10 minutes. So in 10 minutes the rice will be cooked. Well, oh my goodness. Idu enter madbeku bari.
Agadilla.
This is heavy. You got them.
Yes sir.
It doesn't seem like there's too much coal, but I can feel the heat. I can feel that heat of that coal. Oh my god, that is searing hot. Oh my goodness. They want to put some pressure on that biryani. They want to make sure none of the steam escapes. So how do you ensure that? You put this huge cauldron of sherwa on top. You got some live coal and you got this cauldron of sherwa that is sitting on top of the biryani. Saying, I will ensure that you cook on dum before you are worthy enough for me to accompany you in a jonne to the customer.
Idu kuda illu bisi irthade illu matta bisi ide mele bisi ide neat age dum agutte. It's like a driving,
like driving
amaradrunu accident agutte hange.
So the last 5 minutes very important.
Important sir, dum time alli illa andre seedha agutte smell bagutte. So perfect smell barbekandre illi driving
So he says you're almost like a pilot of sorts, bringing your aircraft to land. You've had a good flight for 1 hour, but what's important is how you bring it down.
Landers.
And that you bring it down. And that's the process that he's monitoring now. Making sure the flame is barely there, making sure the coals are fired enough, making sure there's enough weight. And he's fine-tuning things as he goes along. I like the fact that he has a stopwatch here. This is an instrument to make sure he brings his plane safely to land. 3 nimsha 26 second 25 second 24 second idu ithara count martira
every day sir. Time is important sir.
Time is important sir. So nange heli idu nimge recipe ellinda bantu idu
sir? Actually idu nanu ondu degree mugid takshana ಒಂದು ಸಿನಿಮಾದಲ್ಲಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ ಅಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿ. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿನ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸರ್ಸು ಮತ್ತು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆಲ್ಲ ಆಚೆ ಕಡೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ತುಂಬ ಕಡೆ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ ತಿನ್ನಲಿಕ್ಕೆ. ಸೊ ನನಗೊಂದು ಟೇಸ್ಟ್ ಬಾಯಿನಲ್ಲಿತ್ತು. ಸೊ ಒಂದಿನ ಟೈಮ್ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದಾಗ ನಾವು ರೂಮಲ್ಲೇ ಪ್ರಿಪ್ರೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಹಿಂದೆ ಒಂದು ಮೋಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಇದೆ. ನನ್ನ ಅಕ್ಕ ಒಬ್ಬರು, ನನ್ನ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರ ಅಕ್ಕ ನನ್ನ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದಿದ್ದರು. ಸೊ ಅವ್ರು ನನಗೆ ಡೈಲಿ ಅಡುಗೆ ಮಾಡಾಕ್ತಿದ್ರು, ಅವ್ರ ಮನೇಲಿ ಇರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ನಾನು ಏನಾದರೂ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಒಂದಿನ ರೈಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿದೆ. 10 ವಿಸಿಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟೆ ವೈಟ್ ರೈಸು,
ಅದು
ರೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗೋಯ್ತು ಅದು. ಸೊ ಅಕ್ಕ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನನಗೆ ಬೈಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಕಣೋ, ನೀನು ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಲ್ಲ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ತೆಗೆದಿಟ್ಟು ನಾನು ಮತ್ತೆ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಡ್ತಿದ್ದಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಅವ್ರಿಗೋಸ್ಕರ ನಾನು ಏನಾದರೂ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಲ್ಲ, ಏನಾದರೂ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಒಂದು ಪಲಾವನ್ನು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಬೇರೆಯವ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಕೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಕೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಪಲಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ಆ ಪಲಾವ್ ಇವಾಗ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಆಗಿದೆ.
ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ 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 ಬಂತು.
ಈ ಥರ ಒಂದು ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಆಗಿದೆ. ನಾನು ಎಲ್ಲೂ ಹೋಟ್ಲಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ನನಗೇನು ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ನಾನೇ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ 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 ಒಂದು ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಪರ್ಫೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತಲ್ಲ ಹಾಗೆ.
ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಮೇಕ್ಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಪರ್ಫೆಕ್ಟ್, ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಜೊನ್ನೆ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ.
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಚಿಕನ್ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಇಸ್ ಹಾಟ್. I love the color of that biryani. That biryani has, like he said, it is yellow with a touch of green.
Natural color, sir. Natural color. This is chili chicken, sir. Naughty style chili.
I love that green.
Yes, sir.
Oh, that chili.
This is mutton chops.
The mutton chops.
So mutton liver.
Mutton liver. Mutton liver with peas, dried peas.
Yes, sir. This one is leg piece, sir. Chicken leg
piece.
Drumsticks, sir. So everything is ready for lunch.
ರೆಡಿ?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್ ರೆಡಿ.
ಓ ಫ್ಯಾಂಟಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್. ಇನ್ನು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಘೀ.
ಎಸ್
ಸರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಜೆಂಟಲ್ ಇನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅರೋಮಾ.
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ದ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟು ಮಚ್ ಮಸಾಲಾ ದಟ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಇನ್. ರೈಟ್? ದ ಮಸಾಲಾ ದಟ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಇನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮಸಾಲಾ ದಟ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಬಿಗಿನಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಲರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ. ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಮಚ್ ಮಸಾಲಾ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ದ ರೈಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಬ್ರೌನಿಶ್.
ಎಸ್.
ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಮಟನ್ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಒಂದು, ಚಿಕನ್ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಒಂದು, ಒಂದು ಚಿಕನ್ ಕಬಾಬ್ ಕೊಡಿ, ಒಂದು ಮಟನ್ ಚಾಪ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡಿ, ಒಂದು ಲಿವರ್ ಕೊಡಿ, ಒಂದು ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ ಚಿಕನ್ ಕೊಡಿ. This is a packed eatery and I finally got a seat at the table. So when you get here, make sure you get in early or else it may be a bit of a wait. Especially if you want to sit down at a table and eat. And even when you sit down, be prepared to share your table with others because that's typically the sort of eatery that this is. We've set out to taste a bunch of dishes here at Halli Jonne Biryani. So of course you begin with a biryani, which we will taste at the end, the chicken biryani and that mutton biryani. And then we have some paya, some kal soup. And this is typically a breakfast order, but they heard I was coming, so they saved a portion of that paya with some idli. And this is an idli that's quite white and fluffy. And I think this idli is a combination of rice and also some sabbaki, which gives it that white color. This idli is almost neon white in its color. And I'm told that's also a quality of the rice. It's a Sela makki that goes into it. And then there is some keema gujju with some peas, very naughty style. You have that mutton liver. And this is a special that happens only on a Wednesday, which is the chili chicken. There is the chops, the mutton, the leg piece, and then of course the accompaniment. So I think this is the chili chicken gravy and this is the leg piece gravy and some masoor bhaji. I'm in a hurry to get to taste all of this, but because they have kept this portion of kal soup aside, I'm going to taste it a bit. Taste the soup first. The goodness of that bone broth. This is a kal soup that's been simmered for hours. Taste this in the morning, this will transport you somewhere else. That rotter has been cooked well in that broth. There's none of that off, slightly animal sort of flavor. All that you're tasting is the goodness, the nourishment of that bone broth. There's a fair bit of coriander that you're tasting, also perhaps some pepper, which gives it that heat. You know, when a trotter is placed like this in a vessel, what happens is the part that's outside gets exposed to the air and cools down. When you bite on it, it feels a little disconcerting because it's cold. So what I like to do is make sure that I bring that paya to the temperature of the broth. That also allows for that gelatin to exude its flavors. That paya is a sort that melts away. There's a bit of the bite that you taste towards the end. But what you want to do is take that idli here, which is white, steaming hot. And it's an idli that looks fluffy, but it does have a bit of a weight. And dunk that. It's a bit sticky in its texture too. Dunk that into that kal soup. You want to ensure that every pore of that idli is burdened with that kal soup. The porous texture of the idli makes it an ideal medium to convey the nutrition of that trotter soup. You're tasting the heat of the pepper and the freshness of the coriander. I think I'm going to very quickly move to that keema gojju. That mince is quite coarse in its grind. You also have bits of the meat. You're tasting a bit of that masala. I think that onion, garlic. There's a bit of rustic rawness to that masala. So I guess after all it's a haldi mane. So this preparation is a sort that you would probably taste in a village, maybe about 100 kilometers from Bengaluru. That idli though is a great combination with that keema. So I found the masala to be a bit harsh, but the fluffy texture of the idli smoothens off, rounds off the flavor of that masala in that keema gojju. Sometimes if the keema is ground too fine, you're not tasting the meat. You want to taste the bite of the meat. And in this, I can taste the bite, the texture of the meat. You can taste a bit of that red chili that goes into this. You know, the more I eat this mutton mince, the more I eat this keema gojju, the more I'm liking it. Initially, when I took it in my mouth, I thought the masala was a little rough. But the more you eat it, and especially with that idli, the more I'm beginning to enjoy it. And what I'm enjoying really here is the texture of that meat. You feel like you're biting into meat, although it's a keema gojju. I think next we will taste some of that chicken leg piece. Get some of that gravy. That chicken is cooked soft and tender all the way down to the bone. You have a bit of the flavor that you're tasting of that ginger garlic paste in this. Perhaps there's some tomatoes too that have gone into this. You have a bit of the pungency of the ginger garlic, but then you also have the acidity of the tomato. You know, the masala flavor in this is very gentle. Naan ense the halli jonne. Halli means the flavors, the masala, it'll be very spicy. But I'm not tasting anything spicy. There is a bit of the heat. It's a sort that's gentle, that's mellow. That idli makes for such a lovely partner to that thick gravy of that chicken leg piece. I'm sure there's some red chili powder that goes into this, but it's not overwhelming my taste buds at all. I think next let's go for that mutton chop. I got some meat here, and I think I also spy a kidney in that chopped gravy. That's called hitting the jackpot. I love the kidney. Get some more meat and that gravy. Chops is hot, busy there. Amele solpa fat kuda ide. There is some fat as well that's clinging on to these chops. I love that lush buttery texture. Bende tara karagi ho gate that fat. And that meat is soft and tender. You can taste a bit of the greens in that masala. You can taste a bit of the coriander. You can detect the heat, that pointed heat of the green chilies. Let's go for that kidney. There's none of that slightly off ammonia laden flavor that you will find in kidney if it's not been cleaned well. This kidney is soft in its texture and has soaked up the flavor of that masala so beautifully well. And next we will go for some more of that idli with that mutton chops gravy. Well, Raju here is insisting that I try this piece. That meat is pink, tender and pink. You know what I'm appreciating here? The masala is light. You taste a bit of the heat that comes from the green chilies. You taste a bit of the freshness of the coriander, perhaps a bit of the mint, and perhaps some of the other spices that go into it. But the spices that go into it, whether it's the garam masala, whether it's the chakke, the lavanga, etc., are all very soft, very subtle in the way they appeal to your palate. I think now that we are on the mutton, let's go to that mutton liver. This mutton liver has some peas floating in it as well. That mutton liver, the gravy is nice, but the liver is slightly tough. Some pieces are a bit tough. The other thing out here is that all the masala, whether it's the onions, the tomatoes, the ginger garlic, the chilies, it's all ground to a paste before it is used to make that gravy. So you get none of the ingredients to your bite. All of them have come together as one in that gravy. I think next let's taste the Wednesday special, which is the chili chicken. So typically when you're tasting a chili chicken elsewhere, you will see quite a few green chilies and you see many of the chili seeds. But out here, barring some strands of the green chili, I don't detect any of the seed. Let's taste that gravy first. You can detect that flavor, that fresh flavor of the green chili. That's the first thing that you taste. But I haven't been assaulted by the heat of that green chili yet. In this chili chicken, that fresh flavor of that green chili is what's more apparent than the heat of the green chili. And that's quite special, that's quite unique. Let's taste it with some of that chicken. You know, this truly is a very different sort of a chili chicken. Typically, when you say chili chicken, what comes to mind is your taste buds facing the onslaught of tons of green chili, the heat that comes from the chili seeds, and the fiery warmth that embraces your palate. But out here, I'm tasting the fresh flavors of the green chili, not so much the heat. I think as they grind the green chilies, they probably strain out much of the seed. And that's why the chilies are more pleasant in the way they greet your taste buds. I think this is the mildest chili chicken that I have ever tasted. The place is noisy, bustling with customers. You feel like you're in a crowded bus stand of sorts, but then everybody is here purely for the food. So if you're okay with this setup, do come here, and if you find a table, sit down and have your biryani very quickly along with your curries. If you don't mind standing, you can stand and eat too. But if you want to enjoy this at leisure, best to take away from Halli Junne Biryani. And now I have bits of green chilies that I'm tasting, but it's only the skin. And somewhere along the way, I can now taste the flavor of the curry leaf in that chili chicken. So if you like your chili chicken fiery, hot and spicy, this one is not for you. But if you don't mind tasting the gentle freshness, the fresh flavors of the green chili, this is certainly something to try. Well, before I get to my biryani, I think I want to taste some of the kebab here. The chicken kebab. There's plenty of curry leaves too. And these curry leaves are toasted crisp. I love the flavor of curry leaf. You place a few curry leaves on anything, completely elevates the flavor. I think when it comes to cooking in South India, the curry leaf is a cook's most favored ingredient. So of course, there's a bit of color that goes into most kebabs, and that's the reason why it's orangish red. But it's food grade color. Let's get to that kebab. The kebab is moist, very hot. I can barely hold it. The chicken is seasoned well. It's not clinging completely to the flavor of that masala, but it's soft, it's moist, it's seasoned well. And I think what's interesting here is the crunch of that batter. I think this is where the curry leaf will help lend some of its toasty, herbaceous flavor to that chicken kebab. In all the dishes that I tasted, but this isn't my most preferred. We've gone with the kal soup, we've tasted the keema goju, not to forget that pristine white idli. We've then tasted the leg piece, that mutton chops, the mutton liver, the chili chicken, but now we are here for the dish that gives this establishment its name, that Halli Junne Biryani. We'll make a beginning with that chicken junne biryani. Busy there though. I can barely hold it. There is a leg piece here. When you see a leg piece, always go for it. Ah, that's a busy biryani. Halli Junne Biryani. You know, what's interesting is the color of this biryani. So typically most of the dunne biryanis that I've eaten are yellowish brown, but this biryani that I'm seeing is almost a pastel yellow with a tinge of green. That's the sort of color that this is. The rice is moist. Also, the grains are separate. What's nice is that every grain of rice here is whole. It hasn't broken down. This is a biryani that you will not smell from half a mile away. This is a biryani that's quite shy in the way it approaches you as it comes to your table. In its color, it's not aggressive, it's not in the least loud. But when you taste the rice, that's when you taste the full-on flavors of what's gone into that biryani. I can definitely taste a bit of the heat of that green chili. I think there's a freshness somewhere of the greens, of the coriander, the mint. The spices that go into this biryani, whether it's the whole spices at the beginning, the star anise, the cinnamon, the cardamom, the cloves, all of them just lend a faint layer of flavor to that biryani. So typically I would taste the biryani just by itself, but Raju here has told me I should taste it with the gravy as well. The gravy definitely adds more of that, the spice, the garam masala flavor, etc. that you taste in that, the spices. But I like that biryani rice just by itself. I think this is a biryani rice that is flavorful, but doesn't punch you in the face with its flavors. The flavors are there for you to seek out. I definitely want to taste more of that rice. And this time with some of the meat. The meat is cooked such that it gently peels away from the bone. The meat is gentle in its flavors and the sort that would benefit from being married with that rice, with that siraga sambar rice. Even that siraga sambar rice, that though on its own is not too effusive in its flavor, does enough to share some of its spice notes with that meat. I must say that of all the donne biryanis that I've tasted, this perhaps is the most delicately spiced donne biryani. All the spices have come together beautifully to round off all the flavors on your palate. And this is a biryani where I'm tasting also the flavor of that siraga sambar rice. The siraga sambar rice has its character, has its flavor. But many a times it gets overwhelmed with the spices that go into the biryani. You don't tend to taste it so much. But in this biryani, I'm also tasting the flavor of that siraga sambar rice. I can taste the pointed heat of that green chili. That for sure is something that I'm tasting from that chicken biryani. Next is that mutton donne biryani. That jhonne, that container fashioned of banana leaves, dried banana leaves, was crisp and crackling when that biryani went into it. But as that bisi-bisi biryani has gone into it, that jhonne has softened, and in the process, I'm sure has also lent some of its flavor, some of its character to that biryani, to that rice. There's some cashew that I'm seeing in this biryani. I think the meat is somewhere in the bottom, just trying to ferret out a piece of the meat and maybe a second piece as well. You know, what's interesting here is that the rice, the color of the rice of the mutton biryani is a shade deeper than that chicken biryani. And I think that is the character of the meat and the fat that intermingles with that rice. And what's also nice is you have some godambi, some cashew. Here the flavors of the rice in this mutton biryani is more rounded, and that's because of the character of the mutton, the meat and the fat. When I tasted the chicken biryani rice, I could definitely taste the pointed spike of some green chili heat. But in this, I'm tasting none of that. All that I'm tasting is the rounded flavor of some spices. Let's go for some of that meat. The meat is moist and pink. When I was tasting the chicken biryani, that chicken was drawing from the flavor of the spices in the rice. But when I'm tasting the mutton biryani, most of the flavor of the meat, of the fat, is what you want to draw from and add to your rice as you combine it with that siraga sambar rice. You know, these biryanis are delicate in their flavor. I've tasted many donne biryanis which punch you in the face with all their flavor. But this biryani is very delicate flavor, light there. I can taste the flavor of the siraga sambar rice. Rice itself has aroma, it has parimala. Kelo sathi biryani li masale jaasti adare the rice do basmati do sumar flavor ide. Adu easily siraga sambar the kammi ide flavor matra ide flavor. Adu flavor hog bidutte. Jaasti spice. So if you're looking for a biryani that's delicate in its flavors, I think tasting this jhonne biryani by itself is just the thing to do. And if you like things a little spicy, request for some gravy. This I think is a chops gravy. Suddenly after tasting this, I tasted the chops earlier. But even there I felt the masalas were very balanced. But after tasting this delicately flavored mutton biryani, suddenly I can taste that full-on effusiveness of the garlic, of the ginger, of the onions in that. That's the shy nature of this jhonne biryani. This of course makes it a lot more heavier in the flavor of the masala. But if you were to ask me, taste first that jhonne biryani just by itself. And then if you feel you need some more masala and more spicing, definitely add in the gravies. But initially, savor it just by itself. at some of the meat and some of the rice. That piece of meat is soft. It's a sort that requires no teeth. I think I'm going to taste some of that Mosuru Bhaji, just to round things off. And as I call a close to my indulgent meaty lunch here at Halli Jonne Biryani. Some fiber at the end of a meaty meal is always welcome. Well, this certainly was an interesting lunch here at Halli Jonne Biryani. I think it's fantastic to see young entrepreneurs do all that they can to succeed. And I think that's the story of Halli Jonne Biryani, of Raju, who began his enterprise out of a pushcart 10 years ago and today has this eatery that caters to between 500 to 1,000 people every day. I think establishments like these serve as inspiration and much needed inspiration, especially in the current uncertain times that we live in. Well, coming to the meal, there certainly was a lot that I tasted today, from that kal soup to that keema gochu, the mutton liver, the chicken leg piece, the mutton chops, the chili chicken, and then of course the kebab and the piece de resistance, the biryanis here, the Halli Jonne biryanis. What I found very interesting and very appealing was that the spicing in all the gravies that I tasted was the sort that didn't punch you with too much heat, too much spice. And sometimes that can be a bit disconcerting. The flavors in these curries were gentle, the sort that allowed you to relish the flavor of the meat. Of course, there are some preparations that I enjoyed more than the others. For instance, that keema gochu that I tasted, initially I thought the flavors were a bit too much, the rawness of that masala was a bit too much, but as I went back to it, with every dunk of that idli, that soon endeared itself to me. That mutton chops is certainly a dish that I will return for. That chili chicken redefines a concept of a chili chicken. It's a chili chicken where I could taste the freshness of the green chili as opposed to the fiery heat of chili seeds. And that Jonne biryani is the sort that's gentle. That Jonne biryani is not your typical Donne biryani, that's effusive with tons and tons of flavor that perhaps comes from the spices and the masala. This Jonne biryani, on the other hand, is delicate, is delicately spiced. It has flavor, but of the delicate kind. It's a biryani that compels you to know it better, bite after bite of that siraga sambar rice. And because the spicing is mellow, it allows you to taste the flavor and character of that siraga sambar rice. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Gourmet on the Road. Until the next time, take care, stay safe, and happy eating.
If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the home page. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As, and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!